To take a photograph is to align the head, the eye, and the heart. It is a way of life. To capture a moment is to seize an instant in time that will never come again. To take a shot 1 second earlier or 1 second later means that that middle moment will be lost forever. This is decisive moment photography, a term that I, Henri Cartier-Bresson, created. An example of this is the photo that I captured in Paris, France, 1932. This approach is what separates photography from all other art forms. And that is why I spent a large majority of my 95 years, 1908 through 2004, proving that photojournalism is an art form just as much as painting and sculpting, which takes hours to execute. I wandered around the entire world with my camera, becoming completely immersed in my environment. Take this photo that I took in Cape Cod, Massachusetts, on July 4, 1947, Independence Day. This woman explained to me that the flagpole over her door was broken, but on such a day as this, one keeps one flag in one's heart. I felt in her a touch of the strength and sturdiness of the American pioneers. That same year, I traveled to Punjab, India, where I spent my time living and capturing a refugee camp for 300,000 people. This particular photo captured the refugees exercising in the camp to drive away exhaustion and hopelessness. That following year, I traveled around China and India. I saw moments of extreme poverty and rare moments of prosperity. Two instances of hope that I experienced both captured the vast difference in wealth in these locations. In Gujarat, India, on the 39th birthday of the king, people pushed over each other when sugar balls were being distributed to the poor. The second instance of this was in Shanghai, China, when the value of the paper money sank, the Kuomintang decided to distribute 40 grams of gold to every person. With a gold rush in December, thousands of citizens came out and waited in line for hours. The police, equipped with the remnants of the armies of the international concession, made only a gesture towards maintaining order. 10 people were crushed to death. From 1968 on, I shifted my focus towards drawing and painting. In 2003, my wife, daughter, and I created the foundation Henri Cartier-Bresson in Paris for the preservation of my work. I received an extraordinary amount of prizes, awards, and honorary doctorates. And today, with the new tools available, I have been able to capture so much more.